bucks. Or a stone hand.
I really need that new herbal essence. Walk blessed.
How's business?
Oh, how nice of you to ask. I can't complain. I suppose the wars in Kilay and Kira make it harder to get your hands on certain wares. But still, life's good. Definitely more comfortable than my time on the road, though.
That's good. Well, your time on the road, you were homeless?
What? No, I was a vagabond, as people like to say. A traveling mage.
Okay. How did you become a vagabond?
You know, I grew up in a village near Duneville. Actually, I had a pretty good childhood there. But when I discovered my magical gifts, well, let's just put it this way. It changed how people treated me, even my own parents. I just felt the need to, I don't know, get out, see some of this world. So after I did the passage to the water, that is, after the order taught me how to use my magic path, I decided not to return to my village and packed my traps and hit the road. Kind of bold, yes. But back then, I didn't care. But I digress.
Apples, dates. So let me guess, we came from Rivervale. Right from the farmer's coast and Duneville. And yeah, she said in the background, Duneville. I'm guessing there are dunes there, so like a desert or beach kind of environment. So you did the passage to the water. How was that?
Hard. The Arcanist made it clear that we stood at the crossroads. Either we learn to control the magic, or we become outlaws. It was not a pleasant time, I can tell you that much. The keepers were extremely strict, and you learned to be independent. To not get too close to anybody. But no offense, that's a very personal topic.
Cool. 14 out of 40 knowledge. What happened to the people who didn't make it to the passage?
As I said, I don't want to talk about it. Sorry.
Oh my. What do you mean by people treated you differently back in your village?
Well, they weren't exactly hostile to me. But it was the small things. Looks, talk going on behind my back. Over time, that just gets to you.
Yeah, I understand.
But you know, I don't think I can blame them. Especially with the village folk. The word magic is always mentioned together with wild magic, Orbeus, and devastated cities. And all of a sudden, here I am. Suddenly one of them who can do those things. Even though I don't have Eterna blood. How is that supposed to fit into their worldview? They can't really know better.
Well, I don't have eternal blood either. So, traveling as a vagabond, you weren't afraid of bandits, for example?
Well, that's one of the upsides of being an Arcanist. You don't need to be a bulk of muscle to defend yourself against a pack of wolves.
True.
Plus, back in those days, the roads were safer by far. All these brigands, the frenzied Vatirs, the lost ones, that's new, for whatever reason.
So she says Vatirs. The others say Vatters, I think. Still sounds tough.
I probably made it sound worse than it was. I've heard that on Nirum, magically gifted people get driven out of their village, or worse. I guess I should consider myself lucky.
Well, show me what you have in stock, then.
Sure. Take a look.
She's got some ambrosia. I have to check, see how much do I have. I have 5. I think that's fine, what I have for now. She's got a whole bunch of teleports. Crafting books. More honey, if you wanted it. These people love honey. You realize that? All the honey we found in the store, and then she's selling honey here. I don't think I need to buy her honey. She I'll buy a pearl to taste it, see its effects. Spell tomes. I'm gonna buy any of these at this time, or even look at them really. A lesser soul gem. Oh, lesser and a petty soul gem. Yeah, I'll take both of them. I'm gonna need to refill my sword and my staves at some point.
Walk blessed.
Why, thank you. I'm just checking to see if there's anything else I might have missed that I picked up. Oh yeah, the ghost wrapping. Restore stamina. There's the pearl. Another restore stamina. Oh, whisper weed, and I have a bunch of them. Did I just kill myself or something? I paralyzed myself.
Fruits, vegetables, bread fresh from the oven. Treat yourself.
Wow. What a rush. Paralyzed, yeah. I thought the world was ending with that sound. Well, that's cool. We can use that to make paralysis arrows or something like that.
Hungry for arcane secrets? I have books, scrolls, potions, anything for friends of path-abiding magic.
She's watching me.
Apples, dates, bananas.
Walk blessed.
Right from the Farmer's Coast and Duneville.
Yeah, it's not gonna work out for me this way. Floorhammer's Forge Work. Let's check it out.
Hammers, daggers, swords. The best from the Calais Archipelago to this beautiful country. Let me know when something catches your interest.
Well, maybe I'll not let you know and just take it. 40 iron arrows. 20 sharp steel arrows, nice.
Looking for steel? I can provide.
You can provide. Darius Floorhammer. What do you have in stock?
Everything for the path-abiding soldier.
Do you have anything for the non-abiding path soldier? Cold Knight. Is this a... That's a great sword, yeah. I want a magical... Well, I do have a magical one-handed sword, but I want to look at others. Yeah, nothing I'm interested in. Lockpicks, maybe? I could see you'd sell lockpicks. No.
Come again.
Hmm? Hi.
Hmm?
What's up, Pod? Podrick? What's back in? I love cheese. Stuck this time? Hey! Don't you be stalking me. Hey! Can't see me anyway. Hey. I know this is your place, but you're being creepy. So I could run down and run back up here really quick to steal this Andralian cotton, but I think I don't need it that badly. Fish? You sell fish?
Renar Shalom, fair lady. Are you looking for fresh fish?
You're not an Andralian, are you?
Kirash, what gave me away? My skin or my accent?
I'm Kile? Both, I guess.
Well, I'll have to work on my disguise then.
Oh, Kyra.
Jokes aside,
Kira.
I am from Kyra.
Kyra.
But I was only 6 years old when my commune came to this country. And I'll have seen my 60th winter next month, so I suppose that makes me as Enderalian as most people around here.
Your 60th winter? Well, beware, because winter is coming. Why did you leave Kyra?
Oh, there were many reasons. Suffice it to say that Kyra isn't the glittering, exotic country of dreams and poems that bards make it out to be. I am glad to live here. You can say what you will about Enderal, but at least it's peaceful.
All right, show me what you have in stock.
Of course, Sherry.
Thank you, but don't call me Sherry. Ooh. Fish meat. Fish eggs. I'll buy it to try it. Going easy on the scum? Who that? Who going easy on that scum? Alright, ingredients. Fish, eggs. Is this poison?
If it's clam and fish you seek, then come and take a good long peek.
That's good, you've been working on that.
Lock blessed, madam. Lock blessed, madam.
Those guys don't have much to say.
Ah, A foreigner, huh? What a surprise.
What a surprise. And the cook also says, what a surprise. It was such a surprise. Watchtower, I can't get in.
Come to your Intoshamgash and buy fish. Only the best and fresh from the Red Sea.
Meh. Melissa Corn? My name is Corn.
Walk blessed. What can I do for you?
How's business?
Honest answer? Bad. Since this whole red madness thing started, the roads aren't safe to travel anymore. At least, not for those who don't have the coin to pay an armed escort. And that's most of us merchants. But, well, you scratch along somehow, don't you? As long as people eat and the farmers deliver, I'll have customers. I really shouldn't complain so much.
It's okay. I'm always a sympathetic ear, well, usually. I wager you talk to a lot of travelers, don't you? I'm an adventurer. Any tips you could give me?
What, you're asking me? I'm flattered. But let me think. You know, my grandfather always used to read to us from this old book, Myths and Legends.
Which one?
I think one of the former Archmagisters of the Order wrote it, and there were all kinds of tales about those mythical creatures that apparently roam Enderal.
I have some of those books.
Grandpa always said they were just tales, but who knows? You should go to the library. Maybe they still have a volume of that book there.
There's a library? They got a library, guys. Okay, show me your wares.
Sure.
She's selling food. That's it. Just food. Okay. I'm good on food.
Come back anytime.
Thanks.
Hungry for arcane secrets? I have books, scrolls, potions, anything for friends of path-abiding magic.
Do you also sell information?
Information? What do you mean?
Sure, why not? Here. I'm an adventurer. I'd wager that you, as a merchant, overhear a lot of useful things.
Let me see. That's not very much, but fine.
It is to me.
A couple of moons ago, I had a really strange guy as a customer. He wore two sabers, like those coal people do, but when he moved, he was really swift about it, like he was some kind of thief.
Coal people?
I think he was an assassin, as they call him. Quiranian contract killers. You can hide within a fortress, but they'll find you. Somehow break into your room and kill you in your sleep. And unlike those everyday scroungers, they know how to wield a sword, like Lorem Waterblade did. Who knows? Maybe that'll help you.
The art of combat. A merchant told me about an assassin who was proficient in both sneaking and fighting. How much money do I have?
My dad.
1321. Yeah, I'll give him another.
Yeah? What do you want?
Do you hear any other stories like that?
What? That wasn't enough?
Shrug.
Let me think. Yeah. There was that wench once. A farmer. She came running into the city as if chased by the Black Guardian.
Black Guardian.
And told the guard something about an ambush on her farm. Nothing unusual, you could say. Especially nowadays, but apparently the bandits were led by a mage. And, well, if you can believe that farmer woman, she conjured the sunfire down from the sky.
Oh, damn.
Green fire, lightning. The living dead rising from the ground. A wild mage. In other words, one of those sinistropes.
Oh, cool.
But she also knew elemental magic like the keepers do. I wouldn't want to come across someone like her.
The merchant told me about a mage who used entropy and elementalism together. I'd rather learn from her than fight her, but, yeah, are your wares for sale?
No. just put them out for you to look at.
Okay, then.
Tell me what you need, and be quick about it.
Kind of quick with the sarcasm there, aren't you? Sharp steel arrows. Skull of Arcane Rune. Explodes for 22 points of shock damage when enemies come near, sweet. We'll sleep. Unduces his key and teleports. The Seraph. Tales of the Wanderer, the Seraph. The Blade Master I have, the Archer. I don't know if I have the Seraph. I'd rather not to keep buying all these things, though. Didn't I have a couple of them from... I thought I found one or two of them at the mayor's house, but I guess not. I bought two of them from Kuro's general store. Alright, the Seraph, I'll buy it. What the hell?
Hungry for arcane secrets? Nah, I just put them out for you to look at. Tell
this
me what
guy.
You need, and be quick about it.
Here, take the Encyclopedia Arcana Magic part when I have that. He'd buy this journal. I don't want to sell it, though. Those are my other Tales of the Wanderer books. Alright, never mind.
Walk blessed.
The way he said it. That goes back to the foreign quarter. We ended up taking a detour away from there because we got arrested. Eterna Minstrels.
Huh? What do you want?
Your soul.
Huh?
This guy still doesn't speak.
So much to do, so little time.
Net a Millerman?
Yes.
I've either talked to her before or she's gonna say the same thing as someone else did. Is this where I can set up my own shop? It's empty. Ooh, I'm searching for you. Let's live. After a long time in solitude, I, Teldor, search for a gentle nature who isn't adverse to a quick adventure. Meet me on the island in front of Ark. There you will find a camp. Read the message and show your gratitude to me. Really? An extraordinary adventure. That sounds fascinating. Search for the camp on the island in Ark's Lake. The brigand wanted at the behest of the Holy Order. The brigand Krako stands accused of a multitude of vile crimes, among them plundering, multiple murder, robbery, and vile speech against Malthus, the Lightborn and the Holy Order itself. Clues that result in his arrest will be generously compensated by the city guard.
Yes?
Yes? Alright, well that's interesting. Let me check this stuff out. I read a poster in Ark. And then it says that, okay. The art of combat. If I want to survive in Enderal's wilderness, I need to become more skillful. Perhaps I can get helpful hints in libraries, ruins, or through conversations. A merchant told me about a mage who used entropy and elementalism together, and sneaking and fighting. Fail. This guy Rogash, I don't like him very much.
Oh well.
Oh, the bank. Interesting that they have a bank.
Walk blessed, my dame. How can Silwyn and friends serve you today? Would you like to open a personal vault? Or perhaps even acquire an estate?
You sound creepy as hell, sorry.
Yes? Madame?
Fine, I'll talk to the creepy guy. What? They have records? These people have records. They have vinyl.
Yes?
Yeah. That's crazy. I mean, I thought when I saw the cannons that was enough, but these guys have vinyl here. You know, we didn't... This is past the wax cylinder. That's what it is, a wax cylinder? Okay.
Walk blessed, my dame. How can Silwyn and friends serve you today? Would you like to open a personal vault? Or perhaps even acquire an estate?
A personal vault?
A ledger. Your very own safe in our house, which we will manage on your behalf. We will meticulously track all your deposits and withdrawals, and best of all... Thanks to our very generous interest rates, the longer you entrust your money with us, the more it proliferates on its own.
How can my money proliferate on its own? It's called interest and stuff, but yeah, this is new to us.
Well, evidently this was a metaphor. Just imagine that for every day your money rests in our vaults, we present you with some extra coin on top of it. As in appreciation for your trust, so to speak.
And that's the way, evidently, most banks get their money as well, by making interest off the money that you put in their bank as well. And I believe they make more than you do. That would make sense, actually. Otherwise, they wouldn't make a profit, right? So what, you do this at your own expense? How can it be profitable for you? I don't know about these matters.
Well... You see, this is a highly complicated process, and I fear it would be a matter of near impossibility to elucidate my response in such a fashion that you would be capable of comprehending it with your, I beg your pardon, most likely quite limited intellectual capabilities. Let us talk about more enjoyable matters instead, such as your money.
Good God. My limited intelligence. Can you believe this guy? Look, if you want my money, you'll tell me what you do with it.
Fine, then. We use it to trade.
You trade with the coin of your customers?
We invest. For example, in promising expeditions on new trade routes. And from the returns those investments yield, we not only pay our employees, but your interest as well. Now, don't you look at me that way. We have to make a living somehow, too.
Oh, Jesus. What happens to my money if your investments turn out to be, mistakes?
Banks do not make mistakes.
You're right.
Didn't your parents teach you this? Now enough of this nonsense and back to business. Do you want to open a gold shelf or not?
A gold shelf. Let me just see what this entails. I want to open a vault.
Very well. We will need a 100 penny deposit to start with. After that, you may make a withdrawal or deposit whenever you would like.
I don't have that much with me right now.
That's regrettable. Then I suggest you come back later.
Interesting.
What blessed! And don't forget, your money is safe with Sylvan and friends. Exceedingly safe.
Greetings.
So, inside the bank is cells? Maybe this is not a prison cell. It's like a vault, right?
Walk blessed.
Walkie times.
Huh? Can I help you?
Nope. Master lock.
Huh? Can I help you? They always go too easy on this.
I beg your pardon. Whole lot of nothing around here. It was all the gold.
My dame. Yeah. It's not as if I didn't tell them that already.
You always talk to yourself in bank vaults?
Madame?
Alright, that was the bank.